recipe that you don't scratch that cost is not something you want to joke with at all. Loads and loads and loads of learning and information and benefits awaits you at the next one. All you need to do is ensure that you register for your next fast track course. We're looking forward to seeing you. Do you want to be financially free? I hope you know that you will retire someday and you probably are desirous of doing business with real estate or investing property for yourself for your use. You need to learn about it before you make that investment. I tell people, you want to buy properties, you want to invest in property one way or the other, don't give it until you attend the next real estate entrepreneurs fast track course. See you there.
One particular instance I will never forget. You gave us a brief and we had all of these challenges.
What do you people call brief?
You as an instruction to say I want to sell this. In this case, it was somebody wanted to sell a property. A woman wanted to sell a property. She had two plots of land, you know, she had built on one, the other one was still free. So she wanted to sell the one she has built on with the property that she has built on it.
Okay. You know?
And this same woman, we said, let's put banner on your property. She said, no, we should not put banner. Okay, can we advertise it? She has to say yes. But each time she will tell you, when you are trying to say, okay, what is the kind of price we should put there? What we're trying to, this is the going rate of property in this place. You will bring out photos
of
when they first built the house. Herself and her husband, she will explain how much they spent on this floor, how it matters to them. Don't you see the value of it? Can you compare it to all these houses they are building these days? And all of those things, you know. So at the end of the day, we even to agree on what price we should put it out was a problem. And what usually ends up with that kind of a situation is that they will ask you to then put a price that is really way above the market. There is a price you put a property in the market, and it says in the waters. Do you understand? Because you may put it there and then withdraw it. Do you know? So in this case, we put out that price and we were marketing, people were coming for inspection, we were taking people and all of that. Do you know that I just got a call one day after all of this stress to say that that property has been sold. What now happened? The landlord that is living opposite her approached her when he realized that she wants to sell, and then maybe brought her a buyer or bought it from her or something.
Now the question I want to ask in situations like that is, okay, after selling that, I know say she knows sell, she get her property. Is there anything like commission for what you
do? That's the problem now.
Are you still entitled to your normal commission or?
That's the problem. You see, in this part of the world, the way agency is done is very funny. And that's why after doing this for like over 15 years, we don't just take briefs and just be running around town. Mm-mm. I don't take briefs that I'm not sure I'm the one working on it. You either give me a sole brief or a joint brief. I don't take multiple briefs. What I mean by multiple briefs, I think we've explained this before in some of our episodes. Multiple brief is the brief that a landlord wants to sell a property. He has told the whole agent in the world. Everybody is working on it. And it is first come, first out.
Sure.
It is whoever sells first.
Just like one landlord wants to rent a room, a room is open for everybody.
It's the person that brings the buyer.
That bring money.
That gets the commission. We don't do that kind of a brief anymore. We rather do joint or we do so. What I mean by joint, if the landlord wants to work with 5 agents, 2 agents, 3 agents, any number of agents more than one, call all of us together and we are working. We know we are working together. We have an arrangement amongst ourselves on how to work together. Then, otherwise, if I'm the one working, even if you say, we give you 3 months, we give you 6 months, I prefer that. Let me know that for 3 months, for 6 months, for 9 months, for 1 year, I want to focus on how I will be able to get you a tenant, how I'll be able to sell your property. So I can expend my resources, time and money, you know, and know that I have a definite way of recouping it, recovering it.
Okay.
Not that I would expend my resources, and at the end of the day, you tell me that when I'm calling for one inspection, that they won't even have the courtesy to tell you where it has gone. It was just like this other one, they didn't call me, sorry. It was when I wanted to make another inspection arrangement that I got to know that it's been sold. So, they won't have the courtesy. It is when you are now calling to say, there is something, I want to do an inspection or something, they will not say, the property is gone. Somebody just paid. Or some will be calling you after, later. They will tell you that, there are other people on that property, they are negotiating now. If you have anybody, try and be fast about it too. As if they are doing you a favor by that news. Is that a favor? Do you understand what I mean? So what I tell people is that, at this stage, if you want to give us brief, we want to know where we stand. We don't do multiple. So what we do with multiple briefs is that we just put it at the back of our mind. Because we can't be expending money
With multiple briefs now, even if it's two or three, if any of them bring buyer, is it that the buyer, is it that the profit will be shared and means...
Okay, you are confusing it. Multiple brief is that so many agents are in property, they are not connected. They are working independently.
Okay, they are not connected.
Joint is what we are talking about. Joint brief is that more than one agent are on a property with the consent of the landlord. They've been brought together as a team. So they will have a working arrangement between themselves.
Yes.
So they have a working arrangement. Usually how it goes is that they may have some shared responsibilities as to how they will administer the property during the process of trying to get it sold.
Okay.
They will have shared responsibilities. Then they would also have sharing formula in terms of when it is sold, how do we share this commission that we've agreed with the landlord? Usually the person who really brings the buyer amongst them gets what they call a lion's share. And the others get according to whatever responsibility they
get,
share.
Maybe elephant share.
According to their responsibilities. And in some cases, it's a particular agent that brought the brief and then brought one or two other agents into a joint agency. You understand? Okay. So sometimes for him bringing the brief, he gets some share more than the other people.
Because
and the person also selling, if it's not the same person, or even if it's different, he gets also some share, then the rest gets...
Which is at least... The joint, you would know what you are working towards.
Yes, you know what you are working towards. Not that you just be
bumpware, bump time.
It's really, really a major problem for a lot of agents.
Look, I want to know the truth on this assertion. It's a general cliche, but I want to know the truth on this assertion.
Okay.
And that is, if person get property, and maybe wife bearing husband inside that property, is it true that most times agents don't always want to sell such property? Some people say that once you bury somebody in the property, it's like you use it to seal it, nobody can sell it. How true is this? Have you ever encountered such funny a question? But that's what we hear.
Very funny question. Okay, now this is what really happens. It's not as if agent would not want to sell. I'm not sure there's any agent that wouldn't want to sell anything,
but
so the problem is the market. People hardly want to buy such properties. And for people to buy, it would also impact on the value of that property. It would drag it down.
Okay.
When you've turned the property into a cemetery.
Hmm.
In fact, in a lot of cases these days, people know that before you even start to, once you start contemplating selling such a property, you have to exhume that body. You take it out.
So they exhume
so the that body? Is not. Of course, they have to move it away now. People, so you've buried your dad, mom, whatever, on the land, right? You don't want to sell it to me. So I should be living with their dead body to immortalize them because what? Do you understand? Do you understand? Why would I be nursing somebody's
dead body?
So Jerry from Abuja.
Good morning, Jerry.
You were saying something about the cherry formula, yes?
Yes, you talk about the lion share.
Yeah.
And the other share.
Well, depending on their rules, anyway.
What do we do to those who don't share at all? They will collect their own money and run.
I have heard situations like that.
Of course, we know that such happens. I would answer that, Jerry. But I want to ask you, this is where I talk about women, so especially the ones way they elderly, when they get brief. You don't experience them too? Maybe say that they're too emotionally attached to the property. They go, they drag, matter, price, they go, they drag. How you inspect, they go, they drag. You don't experience them too?
Yes.
Okay.
It's all over the place.
Most times, these young agents are always scared to defy the so-called people, because those where they receive the lion's share, I have names like that.
Let me tell you.
You're always scared to face them.
No, let me tell you something. You see, so in this profession, okay, we've gone through different phases. There are agents that have no business doing agency.
Yes, now I'm gonna turn them.
They are quacks. Well, that could turn you into something, but develop yourself. You understand what I'm saying? Develop yourself and do things properly. Okay? There is no how you present yourself and do business properly. Yes.
I want you to come back to that. Samuel, good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm fine.
Very well, Samuel.
The engineer is here.
How is Bini today? You didn't get ready for D-Day.
Okay, the engineer is here. Go ahead with your question or contribution.
Okay, well, it depends on what you they invest in, Sha. Okay? Now, for real estate, there are two ways you make money. Rental income and capital appreciation. Okay? Now, depends on what you are doing. If you are doing rental income properties, you make money that way. So, you get rents. And then when you don't tire for rent, you sell, you get your capital appreciation. But if you're doing trading in properties, you buy and you sell, okay? One of the major strategies they tell you or teach you is that you should learn how to buy below market value, okay? Because that helps you to already have some value locked in that you can sell to other people that are, that are in need of the property. Some of them do what?
Like real estate companies, like I think you're going to invest for any of them, like maybe you do
yes, some are open for investments, but I would encourage you to really do your due diligence. Okay? Do your due diligence. Two ways: you can either buy the property from them and you know this is the property, or they may say, okay, we have some investment, be sure that those things are properly structured and you are protected. There are a few things you want to learn. I won't ask you to just jump in and go invest anyhow.
Thank you. I believe you've enjoyed the video that you just watched. You gained a lot, right? Now let me share with you where they say it all starts. It's called the Real Estate Entrepreneurs Fast Track Course. It's a 2-all-day event. 2 days fully packed, teaching you about real estate. Not just teaching you, showing you real estate stuff that you probably would not know. I'll be teaching you as a real estate entrepreneur or someone that is buying real estate for personal use or for investment one way or the other. This is a course you don't want to miss. There is no tool of its kind in the market. It's the best that there is in the market, and you want to be there. Guess what? It is absolutely free. If it is about real estate and it is about investing, particularly in Nigeria, this is a course that you want to attend. For the value that you will gain, it is absolutely free. All you need to do right now is to click on the link and register for the next Real Estate Entrepreneurs Fast Track course. As a real estate entrepreneur or as a owner occupier of a house, this is a course you don't want to miss. So see you at the next Real Estate Entrepreneurs Fast Track course. Click the link below and get registered. Looking forward to seeing you there.